Hey guys, your boy Kurt Pairs, and welcome back to my little FIFA 16 career mode world. Last time I left off, I picked up wins over Sunderland and Norwich, which in the league. And in this episode, we have a League Cup game against Notts County, as you can see. He's first up, and then we will have a league game against West Bromwich Albion. Now, in the last episode, I picked up two very promising young Brazilian wingers. Merilis, I hope I said his name correctly. He's 17 years old, 6'1", can play left mid or cam. Standard Brazilian stuff, 3-star weak foot, 4-star skills, that's standard stuff. And Brito, which doesn't sound Brazilian at all, sounds like a British name. He is 16, he's 5'6". He can play right, his main position is the right mid, but he can play center or on the left. Right. Well, he has low attacking rates, which is odd, and he has high defensive rates, which make me think this guy should be a CDM, not a winger, because he doesn't even have the pace, if I pressed the right goddamn button. You look at his acceleration and his sprint speed, they're terrible. Not at all like a winger. He should be sitting here where Pollitt is. By the way, Pollitt and Costa are two amazing young talents in their cell. Whereas Pollitt is like a much younger of Fellaini with better hair as well. So, all the ups. Seriously, 6'6". He's just... Judging by his stats, he seems like he's going to be a brick Belgian wall. Or a Belgian brick wall. If I can word my words correctly. And Costa looks like a more pacier version of David Silva. In fact, he's the only one of the four I have used before. I used him in preseason. And he came on. He actually scored a goal or two, if memory serves me correctly. So, not completely he unknowns. And I also picked up a decent keeper who is in goal for this match. So, a lot of the young talent getting a run out in this match. And here is Martin Costa. Since he's Spanish, I wonder if he's anything to Diego. Where if he was. Here's Merilis. Martin Costa, Brito. Seriously, that doesn't sound Brazilian. Now maybe he'll get a comment and saying, "Oh, it's Brazilian." All right. And if you guys can tell me if that's Brazilian, but it doesn't sound Brazilian. Come on. He bumped into my brick wall. Well, he got injured. Whoopsie. He dumbass. Moving forward with some danger to the opposition now they're here. It's a penalty. What? Are you blowing smoke out your backside? How was that not a penalty? What complete and utter bullshit.
That's a good challenge between the two of them there.
Alright. Let's move on from that. Mirrorless. Is it mirrorless or is it, would it be pronounced like Morales? Like the guy, like that weird Portuguese guy he Liverpool signed for a season or two until he joined Chelsea. Maybe that's how it's pronounced, I don't know. Skugel to Moreno, back to Skugel, Costa, Brito. That was a terrible pass, but somehow found its way to who I was looking to go to. Yes, pull it! My center defensive mid. It. Seriously, look at the size of this guy. Yo, if he all he needs is big, bulge, muscles, he'd be like the white Akinfenwa. Wait, that sounds racist. Oh, that didn't sound racist. Crap, that sounded racist. I apologize if that sounded racist. Because I did not mean that to sound racist. But it did. Whoops. My bad. I apologize. Because I'm deeply, deeply sorry. See, he is a huge dude. Huge. Seriously, look at, he is miles bigger than anyone else on my pitch. He makes Sewell, who I believe is my tallest defender, look tiny. Seriously, he makes everyone look flipping tiny.
He tried his luck from a long way out, but the goalkeeper had no problems at all. He's cut out that pass, it wasn't an accident.
Also, look at him. Low attacking work rate. Yeah, he's in the box again. I'm mind him making runs. As long as he gets back in time to cover the counter attack. Especially if they counter attack. That's what I'm worried about. Oops. In the back of my mind, I'm always preparing for a counter attack if my attack doesn't go as planned. Oh, what? How did that not go in? Oh, bollocks. Now I have to prevent said counter attack. Sue's got this. Look at that. Boom, he just manhandled little Campbell. Well, get on my level, son. And the goalkeeper is touching the ball for the very first time in this match and in his whole career so far. Oh, they're praising the shit out of Pullet now. Come on, Alberto. Oh, come on, Alberto. You gotta give me a reason to keep you around. And I said I'd give you a chance, and that's what I'm giving you. But you have to take advantage of that. Chance. And Ings is just chilling on the bench waiting for his time to shine. Costa somehow avoided a challenge there. I'll easily go off for a throw, thank you. Go Mirrorless. Go wherever your name is. Go. I will we'll try and learn how to pronounce it later.
Possibly a chance to add to their lead.
Can that really be counted as a save? Wasn't really much of a shot that led to it. Let's come back over to Sewell. Merilles. Ooh! Do not underestimate the sheer striking power of a Brazilian. That keeper knew. Ooh. He had to be sure that wasn't going to go in. Because if that's on target, probably it would have gone in display his best effort. This this guy, he's no small guy himself. Oof. He's only 6'1". And this game makes him look really way taller. Seriously, I'm 6'1". This guy looks like if I was standing next to him, I think he'd dwarf me. We're the same freaking height. Oh wow, even offside you can't put the ball in the back of the net. God damn it. Hey Costa. This is why no one wants to loan you. Yo, where was the run? Where was the run from you, Alberto? Oh, he's giving it straight to Costa! Blows it over the bar, you shitty! Wait, what? What are we going? Yeah, you shitty. I'm not I'm meant to say shithead, but apparently I've created a new insult. You're a shitty. You Costa. Hey, you have to live with that. Origi, easy tap in 2-0. Thank you very much. Why did that take so long? I should be winning this match 4-5-0. No disrespect to North County, but they're a League One side at last check. They might have gotten promoted last season. I didn't. To check to see who got promoted from what division. All he was interested in the Premier League. If it doesn't involve, if Liverpool aren't in the competition, I'm not really interested in it. Unless I'm doing a secondary career mode, but then I would focus on the team I am doing the career. I have no reason to be interested in Notts County's affairs. There's, unless he did get promoted last season, they're top of the fucking championship. But I won't have to concern myself with that stuff. Not yet, anyway. Maybe somewhere down the line we'll meet in the Premier League, Notts County. Arsenal were playing Spurs. You don't mirror real life anymore, her game. And that's what happened in real life. If a derby. Derby in the cup. Boom. That is so simple. Like, bam! It's like a gun going off. Why were... Oh, Champions League. Duh. Who did I get in my group? CSK Moscow, Celtic, and Inter Milan? Yeah, that's not exactly... Those aren't... I mean, no disrespect, but... Yeah, that's not exactly a tough group. That's my Champions League group? I mean, you know, I'd have to be the favorites in that group, with Inter Milan favorites to get second. Celtic will probably bottom that group, unfortunately. Yo, that is probably the easiest group I've ever gotten in the Champions League. Bayern, Seville, sorry, yeah, Bayern, what did I say, sorry, Bayern, Seville, Lyon, Basel, Atletico Madrid, Borussia Mönchengladbach, Sporting and Olympiacos. Not an odd group. Man United, Juventus, Marseille, Wolfsburg. Okay, the groups are getting tougher. So far, Manchester United have a way tougher group than me. Wolfsburg and Juventus and Marseille. No easy game there. Arsenal. Ooh, Arsenal must go up against the as Mr. Zlatan Ibrahimovic, which is not going to be fun. And they go with and Leverkusen and Copenhagen. Copenhagen will probably be Arsenal's easiest match there. And they're not going to be an easy match. Chelsea got Porto like in real life. Spartak Moscow and Feyenoord. Real Madrid, Milan, Ajax and Midtjylland. Barca, Zenit, Besiktas and Anderlecht. And we're back to us. Yeah, those are. I think Man United got the toughest group. That's weird. When you say that line, you like, wait, what? United, who always end up getting the easiest groups, they got the toughest group. I got the easiest group. No disrespect to those three clubs. I managed Inter last FIFA, remember. Or so you know I don't mean disrespect, but come on. Liverpool could top that group in real life. Hands down. With the squad we currently have. Even with all the injuries. Really sounds like I'm trying to disrespect those teams. I'm not. I really am not. That's not what I'm saying at all. I sound like the biggest dick ever at the moment. You know what? Let's focus on going to the Horfans to play the Baggies. Shall we? Sounds like a plan. Take it 4-4. Maybe, just maybe, Man United will slip up again and we'll open a 5-point gap to them. Or a 4-point gap. I will take a 4-point gap. Here I'm going to be continuing my run because Coutinho, one of the smallest players on the pitch. It's definitely one of the smallest on my team. Don't know the heights of the players on the West Brom team. I don't know of them that well. Oh, but in any event, the little Brazilian magician scores a header. Second goal in as many games because he scored against Norwich. In the last episode. So yeah, you got the... He actually got the last goal against North, which for those of you who saw that video on Thursday. He got the last league goal in the last episode. He got the first league goal in this episode. And that's a corner. Thank you very much. I think it was,
And he bangs it away. And here's the shot.
No, wait a minute. For some reason I was thinking that was Julian Lescott, but he goes, actually it is! I knew it was! I was like, wait, that is Lescott! I was like, that kind of looks like Lescott. It actually is Lescott. I'm not going crazy, it is Lescott. I was going to say, that's Lescott. But then I remembered, hang on a second, he doesn't play for West Brom. I forgot, transfers! I don't know why. Yeah, I thought it might not be Lescott. Oh, jeez. I was thinking, that's Julian Lescott, but then I was saying, oh, it can't be Julian Lescott. And that would sound racist. But actually was Julian Lescott. So there you go. Oh, I do know some players. There you go. I know Julian Lescott well enough to spot him. Even in a West Brom shirt. So apparently in... Don't know why I... Oh, I forgot that. I don't know why I doubted it was Julian Lescott. In any event, whether it's Julian Lescott or not, it's definitely Julian Lescott. I think I've said Lescott's name enough in this episode. I'm not going to say it anymore, unless it's warranted. Like, unless he scores or pulls off an amazing block or concedes a penalty. Unless it's warranted, I'm not going to say his name again. Knowing him, say who it is, because you know, all know what defender I'm talking about. Rondon, on the other hand, is trying to be a pain in my ass. That's no thank you, my friend. And I don't need you who to add to my backside pains. It's cause, and there's the medicine I needed. A goal for Correa's third of the season. First goal in three. It's three from four matches, which in theory sounds good, but he scored two of those in the first one. Then he went on a mini two-game drought, and now he scored again. Although if you guys saw the game against Sunderland, you'll say he should be on four. Well, I think he should be on four. Those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, go watch the last episode. Oh, genius. It was some weird shit. To put it like that. To put it bluntly. Gareth Bale. Yeah, what happened was weird. It was definitely weird. Michael Lewis! Oof! I thought Royce would hit that first time on us. He'd volley, but no, not exactly a bicycle kick. Coutinho! Imagine if he scored another head. That was so fucking retarded. Yeah. See, who am I playing? They're not playing today. Brilliant. Arsenal are winning. Chelsea haven't started their match yet. They must be the late kickoff. Everton are losing, so there's an upside there. And Newcastle are losing to Middlesbrough. I say that because I saw in the last episode, Newcastle are bottom of the table and have not won a game yet. Doesn't bode well when you think none of their games have been against me. So I've actually played their rival Sunderland. There is that for them. The Sunderland are getting too far ahead of them. Whoa, Laporte. He's short. Probably should have passed it. Don't know why I'm only thinking of this now. In any event. Here's Bell. Gets past McLean. There, McLean. Come on. Pick when you were already. Well, penalty. Oh, come on. That was a terrible foul from that defender, whose name I won't repeat in this episode again unless it's warranted. I would have said his name if the penalty had been given, but the referee is an idiot. So that defender gets away without a mention. Sturridge, that was a terrible header for Daniel. Speaking of Sunderland, it looks like they're for the next game for West Brom. Henderson. Great pass to Sturridge. He loses the ball though. McLean. McLean wins it back. He almost gave it straight to Rondon. Sturridge. Plays through Bale. Henderson hits that first time in Gamboa. We're a tremendous block. Mark potentially he preventing a goal? Huh. So they've decided a strong target man is not what they need. They need pace to defeat my defense. They're bringing on Berahino. It's realistic. That's what they do in real life, is rotate. He does too. And Coutinho scores a second header. Come here, Bale. Oh, good. Yeah, hug. Oh. Coutinho was like, fuck, give me Bale a hug. I'm going to kick that corner flag. I'm so angry at the corner flags. It's a second in goal for Coutinho in this match. It's a second header. In off the post, yes, but second header nonetheless from one of the smallest players on the pitch. Going to bring that up every time he scores a header. It's not something to be proud of when you're beaten by one of the smallest players on the pitch. And it was a header. I mean, if he'd scored with his boot, there would be no need to mention in his height. But when you're beaten in... Her scores from a head. Don't feel good. And I finally got that freaking achievement. I thought you had to. I've been trying to get that freaking trophy for ages and finally fucking got it. Despite having countless times scored 2 goals from corners. In multiple matches, it's this one that finally gives me the achievement. Thank you, Marco. Ooh, that is a huge weight off my back. Oh yeah, and that's also 4-0. So, thanks for that as well. There's that defender. Use it to Pogani? Gardner. Has it now. That's how I can pronounce his name. Wait, how did you not get that career? God damn it. He's Garner again. Give it straight to Klein, but he gave it straight back to Garner. He's like, let's play a bit of 1-2. Oof, who shall we? He died, so they brought on a second striker. Not really gonna help when you're 4-0 down. Henderson! Ooh, Henderson's still looking for his first goal of the season. He's looking. He didn't find it. Don't know why I hit that. Shouldn't have hit that. There's the full-time whistle. So So a nice 4-0 win. Bale got the highest rating. You do remember Coutinho scoring 2 goals game? Apparently not. Arsenal with that. Picked up a 2-0 win over Villa. That should get them away from the relegation zone. Because they were struggling down there for some reason. So yeah. Woo! Morales has gone up to a 55 rated player. Oh, hell yeah. So in the next episode, I'll pick up after the end of the transfer window. I won't be making any more signings. But maybe some of my players may actually go out on loan. I know, crazy to think my players might actually go out on loan. Hang on, are they actually listed? I'm just thinking, why am I just thinking of this now? No, not you. You. That might be why they're not being approached. But that doesn't explain the other players who are listed for loan. Huh. See if there's anyone else I missed. Nope. Okay. I think it's, yeah, we're good. Good. Thanks for watching. This episode, I hope you enjoyed it. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe if you did. And I'll see you all in the next.